Let's take a look at what's new in Vocaloid 6. Vocaloid is a software instrument used to create digital vocals with your computer. And the latest addition to this software with Vocaloid 6 is the use of AI technology to deliver a natural, humanized sound and the ability to transform your own recorded vocals to the sound of a Vocaloid voice bank. As for the compatibility of Vocaloid 6, there's two main things to focus on: opening previous versions of Vocaloid voice banks and opening previous versions of Vocaloid sequence files and project files. So, first with the voice banks. All previous versions of Vocaloid are compatible with Vocaloid 6. For Vocaloid 3, 4, and 5 voice banks, no modifications are needed, and you can simply choose any singers you'd like to work with. For example, I can create a Vocaloid part, write notes, add some lyrics,
I'll sing for you,
adjust the attack and release effects,
I'll sing for you,
and choose the singer of my choice.
I'll sing for you.
Now for the Vocaloid sequence files and project files, all files saved from the Vocaloid 3, 4, or 5 editor can be loaded in Vocaloid 6. For example, I can open this VPR file saved with Vocaloid 5, and all of the tracks open up in Vocaloid 6 exactly as they were in Vocaloid 5. Something to note is that all Vocaloid 5 functions remain in Vocaloid 6. So for anybody switching over from Vocaloid 5, have no worries because you'll be able to continue where you left off, plus create even more. Now for the included voice banks. Vocaloid 6 comes with 8 voice banks, 4 voice banks in the new Vocaloid 6 AI voice bank pack, in addition to 4 Vocaloid 5 voice banks. As for the Vocaloid 6 AI voice bank pack, this is where things get exciting. This pack includes 2 male and 2 female singers. And based on previous versions of Vocaloid, you may assume these are separate English and Japanese singers. But here's the best part. They're all bilingual, meaning you can input a variety of languages in a single or multiple parts. For example, English or Japanese. And the singer can sing both of these with natural pronunciation. For example, I have this part here. I'll write some English lyrics.
Please don't cry. Show your eyes.
And finish this part off with some Japanese lyrics.
Please don't cry.
From here, we can easily change the singer.
Please don't cry.
Along with the notes or octave, the singer is singing.
Please don't cry. Monetanaide.
As for the new features of Vocaloid 6, we have 4 main things to introduce here: the new Vocaloid AI synthesis engine, the Vocalo changer, ARA2 integration, and SMF exporting capabilities. So first, the Vocaloid AI synthesis engine. This is a brand new synth engine that uses AI technology to create a more natural and humanized voice. The 4 voice banks used on the Vocaloid AI tracks all use this new synthesis engine. So by simply creating a Vocaloid AI track, I can choose a voice and write in some notes and lyrics.
Please don't cry.
You can hear, even with large pitch jumps, the singer keeps the natural tone and feel.
Please don't cry.
And this sounds great at various octaves as well.
Please don't cry.
And the simple reason for why this works is that the engine uses deep learning to analyze singing characteristics, such as tone and expression, with real recordings of singing. So whatever notes and lyrics you write in will be automatically adjusted to sound as natural as possible. As for the Vocaloid changer, This is an incredible new feature, as you can now convert your own voice or any recorded vocals into a Vocaloid AI voice bank voice. Simply add audio to an audio track.
Keep on staring, staring.
And choose the voice bank you'd like to convert the sound of your voice to.
Keep on staring, staring.
This is incredibly useful for seamlessly combining recorded vocals in a song with Vocaloid AI parts. Next, we have the integration of ARA2. ARA2 is a replacement for Rewire, so any ARA2 compatible DAWs can seamlessly integrate Vocaloid 6 as a quick and easy extension. To learn more about setting this up with your own DAW, we have articles on the official Vocaloid website to get you started. And last, we have SMF exporting. Simply put, SMF export allows you to export the MIDI files from your entire Vocaloid 6 project. This is incredibly useful to quickly and easily export each individual Vocaloid part into their own MIDI files that can be opened up in a DAW, for example. This MIDI can be further edited or even utilized as a template to build a musical arrangement around. The choices are endless. The new Vocaloid 6 editor has noticeable improvements as well. This includes updated editing tools, a new zoom full feature, improved track adding options, the ability to easily move Vocaloid and Vocaloid AI parts, and the new inspector switch. Let's first take a look at the updated editing tools. The first thing to note are the mute and solo cut buttons. These are buttons that easily cut all mute or solo switches. This was a big feature request from Vocaloid 5 that is a great addition to improve a seamless workflow when creating music. Next, we have these three buttons to view the time signature, tempo, and main tracks. You can simply enable these buttons to show or hide the track. These options are still available in the View drop-down menu, but these buttons can be a quick solution to show and hide each of these tracks. And as far as quick solutions go, there's a new keyboard shortcut to quickly enable the repeat from the transport. Simply highlight a region of a single or multiple parts and hit the P key to easily enable the repeat. This will play back the region in a continuous loop. As for a new zoom feature, here's something that's super helpful. From the View dropdown, we can go down to Zoom and choose Zoom Full. This will automatically zoom to fit the entire amount of parts you have in your project on the screen. So whether you have a few parts in a small range, all the way to a full arrangement of parts, you can easily fit the zoom to see everything you need and understand exactly how long the length of your project is. Now for adding a track, there's a new button up here that brings up this window to add a new track with a few useful features as well. The first is the ability to choose the type of track. So Vocaloid AI track, Vocaloid track, or audio track. You can write the name of the track, the amount of tracks to add into the project, the length of bars for the parts added, and noting that this can be zero if you don't want to add in any parts, and you can choose the singer for these parts added in. Note that these singers will change depending on the type of track you're choosing, this being a Vocaloid AI track or a Vocaloid track. And here's something really useful you can do with these parts. Let's say I have a Vocaloid AI track with a part written in there. I can easily move this over to a Vocaloid track. And the notes and lyrics all remain, allowing this part to be used with a voice bank compatible for a Vocaloid track.
Please don't cry.
And I can interchange these at any time to switch between the parts to utilize different voice banks and features for each track. And to dive even further into what each of these parts offer, the inspector switch will open up the inspector, filled with editing options for the specific part. Now for the musical editor. There are a variety of new updates here to enhance not only your workflow, but the capabilities of how you can edit your music with Vocaloid 6. This includes an upgraded line tool and note editing tools. For the line tool, this is a new addition that can be found under the pencil tool. Simply click and hold and choose the line tool. With this, you can easily draw straight lines. This is an incredibly simple but effective editing tool when it comes to drawing in smooth and consistent edits.
Please don't cry.
And you still have the option to draw freely when disabling the grid, allowing you to create natural movement while maintaining consistency with your edits.
Please don't cry.
Now for the note editing tools. There are a variety of new editing tools for Vocaloid AI Voicebanks. This includes updated pitch, vibrato, expression, timing, and take functions. And all these options can be found above the musical editor. The great thing about these options is that it's so incredibly easy to edit with them. For example, with the pitch adjustment, you can simply drag vertically on any of these six dots, and you can immediately see how the note pitch is being adjusted based on the orange line on the note.
Please don't cry, don't cry.
And these parameters can be seen from the inspector as well for additional insight and editing for the parameter amounts. You can do the same with the vibrato by controlling the depth, the rate, and the starting point of the vibrato.
Please don't cry.
With these three parameters, you can easily adjust a vibrato that feels and sounds exactly how you want.
Please don't cry.
And then we have the expression, which is essentially a volume adjustment. You can easily control not only how the note sounds, but how it feels with these simple adjustments of volume and expression.
Please don't cry.
And then we have the timing. This adjusts the timing of when the note starts and ends. The interesting thing here is that it isn't simply a start and end of the note in general. It's more so an adjustment of the start and end of each consonant and vowel in a single word, and how these connect with other words. For example, I have this part.
Hey there, friend.
And I can adjust not only when the note starts and ends, but I can control exactly when specific consonants and vowels are sung, like the word friend. I can adjust when the F, R, E, N, and D sounds of the words start and end. And you could do this with every word to naturally connect not only words, but the natural feel of how consonants and vowels are spoken within each of these words.
Hey there, friend.
And last, we have the take function. This is a really great new feature that allows you to simply create a new version of your singer that is singing the same notes and lyrics with a slightly different feel, as if a new take was recorded with natural differences. Simply copy and paste a track or a part and choose a new take. The notes are still in the same place, but the timing of them are slightly different.
Please don't cry, show your eyes.
This is very useful for creating a natural doubling effect when layering multiple parts together. The use of these slight nuances of timing will make these doubled vocals sound incredibly full and natural.
Please don't cry.
And as a pro tip, adjust the octave of some of the parts to create an even bigger sound.
Please don't cry. Show your eyes.
From there, you can apply this to any parts you like and even spread out the stereo width of the vocals with the mixer panning.
Please don't cry, show your eyes. Please don't cry, show your eyes.
And there you have it. That's a full walkthrough of what's new in Vocaloid 6. To learn even more, head over to the official Vocaloid website.